Hello and welcome to PA Academy. So in this video, I'm going to be showing you how to draw a tangent to an involute. So in the previous part of this video, I showed how to go ahead to draw the involute of a circle, which we are having here. But now, what if you are asked to draw a tangent to it from a particular point on the involute? So let's pick a point. So let's say we want to have a tangent on just any point. You can just pick any point on, let's say, on this point now. On this point, so let's call it, so this is the point, let me put this arrow so that you can see. So I pick the points here, and then let's call that point M. So let me call it point M. That's okay, this is where we want our tangents to be. So before we continue into this video, please, if you are yet to subscribe to PA Academy, please click on the subscribe button. It's absolutely free. Please click on the subscribe button to subscribe to this channel. Alright, thank you very much if you have just done that. So let's continue. So now we've picked our points. The next thing we are going to do is we are going to draw a line from this point, I call it point M, to the center of the circle. So, the next thing to do is, from the center of this circle, let's call it point O. Point O. So with that, we are going to draw a semicircle. On this point OM, we are going to draw a semicircle. So in doing that, for us to do it now, we have to get the center of this line OM. And in doing that, we need to bisect this line in order to get the middle of this line. So I'll be using my compass, easy to measure the length of OM. So I already have it to the length of OM. I'm going to draw an arc here and another arc here. So with the same length, I'll place it on point O. Draw an arc. And then draw an arc. So their point of intersection, I'm going to join it together. So I haven't joined it. So where it is touching line OM. So it is touching line OM on at this point. So this represents the center of the semicircle that we are going to draw. So I'm going to bring in my compass again, place it on this at the center of line OM, so I can use it to get the length or the radius of the semicircle. So I place my compass directly on it and adjust it to point O or to point M. So you can also pick your ruler and measure it. Once you measure it, you bring your compass and then you measure it on your ruler, whichever way is convenient to you, so you can just apply it. So once I place it at the center, since I've gotten the length from this the center of OM to point O, I'll go ahead and draw a semicircle. So now I already have my semicircle. Another thing we have to note now, after drawing your semicircle, is for you to note the point where the semicircle is touching the circumference of this particular circle. This circle that we are having here, where this semicircle that we have just drawn is touching it. It's touching it at this point here. So let's call that point N. So let me call this point N, this point. So what we have to do next, we are going to join point M to point N. We are going to draw a line from point M to point N. So this line that I've just drawn is what we call the normal. So if you are asked to draw a normal to an involute of a circle now, so this is how you go about it. You already have a normal. So let me call it, let me name this. So this line we are having here is called the normal. That is the normal. So for us to now get the tangent, so that means we are going to draw a line that will be at perpendicular to this line from this point M. So what I mean is that we are going to have a line that is at 90 degrees to this normal. So that means our tangent will be coming like this, but it must be at 90 degrees to the normal. So in drawing that perpendicular line, you can either pick your protractor, then you place it on the normal. You use it to get your 90 degree. That is one way. Then another way of getting this done is, you want to pick your compass at any convenient length. You are going to use it to draw more like a semicircle on the normal, to touch the normal. You're going to be having something like this. So I hope you can see it. Let me make it bold. But it should be a faint line anyway. So I hope you can see it. So this is it here. So what with the same length, you place it where it is touching the normal. you bisect the arc that we've just drawn with the same length where it is touching that arc I drew the first one. So you place it there, you bisect it again. So now we have these two intersection. Where it is touching this circle that I've drawn here, this semicircle on this side. So now I can decide to adjust the length of my protractor, of my compass. So with that, I'm going to draw an arc on this part with the same length. I'll come here and draw an arc. So from the point of intersection, this is the point of intersection, I'm going to join it to M. And this line here represents our tangent. So let me write it on its tangent. So this is the tangent. This is the line from here, like this, represent the tangent. So this is the normal. This is the normal. So this is how you go about if you are asked to draw a tangent or a normal to an involute. Now, if you missed the first part of this video where I showed you how to draw this involute, so just watch this video to the end. That video is going to be coming up immediately after this video somewhere here. So once you click on it, it will take you there. And also in the description of this video, there are a lot of links there that will show you how to draw other diagrams that like this, like how to draw the cycloid, the epicycloid, the hyperbola, the helix, and how to draw their tangent and their normal. So just check the description of this video, you'll find the links to those videos, which I believe will be of help to you. So if you have any question or any comments or any video requests, just leave them in the comment section below. And if you are yet to subscribe to PE Academy, please take your time to click on the subscribe button. Also give this video a thumbs up. Help give this video a thumbs up. Also share this video. And you can check the playlist also. Do check our playlist on technical and engineering drawing. There are a lot of videos, there are over 100 videos I believe will be of help to you. You can also check our website, paacademy.co. paacademy.co. And I'll see you all in another video. Meanwhile, the video that should show you how to draw an involute will come up right here. Right, thank you.